does think if you say something out loud enough times, it becomes legal, because he's not only blatantly admitting he asked the Ukraine for dirt on the Bidens, he wants to expand the investigation. Watch.
By the way, likewise, China should start an investigation into the Bidens, because what happened in China is just about as bad as what happened with Ukraine.
No details, you know, just throws it out there. He started a trade war with China. Is he dangling another quid pro quo here? And I thought the Chinese were his mortal enemy. All of a sudden, he's in bed with the Chinese.
No, he tweeted out, what did he tweet out the other day? Like, congratulations on the anniversary?
Yeah.
I mean,
he also said yesterday, he said, because they were asking about the trade war, he said, I have a lot of options on China, but if they don't do what we want, we have tremendous power. And it was only 30 seconds later that then he talked about the investigation. And so when you talk about, like, maybe we're more leveled with China compared to us in Ukraine. But when it comes to the trade war, he's more in the driver's seat.
But you know, one of the points that really bothers me about this entire thing is the hypocrisy, right? I mean, just the sheer hypocrisy of it. Yesterday, Pence, Vice President Pence said, worth looking into any impropriety involving the Bidens. Well, you can change that for the Trumps, right? And Pence says, when you hold the second highest office in the land, it comes with the unique responsibilities not just to be above impropriety, but to have to appear that there's no impropriety. The Trumps, you know, Ivanka's getting trademarked from China.
A lot of trademarks in China,
Kushners are trying to get bailed out from their disastrous real estate deals. Mar-a-Lago, the fees got hiked up 100% when he became president. Mm-hmm. There's a bunch of foreign governments staying in the hotel in D.C.
Isn't, so you know what? Hunter just as bad, though? I mean, so now the prosecutor in Ukraine, they're going to reopen the investigation. They say there's something criminal, but they want to see how this happened, if there was any wrongdoing there with Burisma.
But thus far, there's no indication that there's
nothing on the Bidens.
I'm saying there may not be illegal, but if we're going to, this whole hypocrisy, whatever, it's all across the board. It's abuses of power. It's using
your
leverage.
I don't agree that it's,
I think you have to look
up
to Congress, too. You know, there's a bunch of children and spouses who are in lobbying shops all over the place because of the connections and networking. And I don't think,
This is why I don't think this is good for Biden. And you know, people aren't talking about that piece of the puzzle as much as Trump. But every day that he's in the headlines and his son is in the headlines about this, and
even
about
though it's,
a,
even
power,
though it's false accusation, yeah,
that's the problem.
The worst thing is he's accused of really is nepotism, and Trump's got three. How many relatives are working in the White House? It's like they don't have any
working
other place
in the
to
White
live.
House. And that was my the point that I was trying to make. I mean, there is no. There's no truth to the fact that Hunter Biden did anything illegal. Right. And the other point is Hunter Biden wasn't a member of the Obama administration, whereas Ivanka Trump is a member of the administration. Jared Kushner is a member of the administration. And they are benefiting from that administration.
I really do.
I
think it's all
bad.
That's
worse.
Don't swipe like that.
Well, not doing something illegal doesn't mean that it doesn't.
It's not the same thing.
That it doesn't smell funny.
I mean,
I agree
with that. He's petrified of Joe Biden. Let's face the facts. Well, and that's why he'll probably be the
nominee. He also brought up Warren
nominee.
On the China call, too, by the way.
Oh, yeah, well.
Warren and Biden, which is